This is probably one of the worst ideas I've had. Come on, baby, come on. All right. So I'm out here, I'm chasing the white whale. I'm trying to have a drone that can land in water and then be submersed and then take off again. I've tried many different things. I've tried liquid electrical tape. I've tried conformal coating. I've tried the combination of the two. I feel like I was close, but it was just like, the problem is with those things that there's still gaps that seem to get filled with water once it's submersed. It might be water resistant, but it's not actually completely waterproofed. So I'm out here, I'm by a canal. I just applied some FPV Worry Free all over this beautiful brand new Apex build that I'm gonna dunk in water, as you can hear it behind me. And I'm gonna pray that it works. And if it doesn't work, I brought this guy to retrieve it. And then if everything goes well, I'm gonna rinse it off and then we're gonna go just do some laps around the canal. So let's see what happens. This is probably one of the worst ideas I've had, but you know, let's hope for the best, right? This is gonna be stressful. Decide to do this midday, right? Come on, baby, come on. Come on, baby. Maybe next time I should just try the pool, right? Okay, let me see if it still works. I guess it works. I couldn't get it out of the water, but at least it still works. All right, I'm back. I'm dry. This is the next day after that whole mishap. So a bunch of things I learned using FPV Worry Free. The texture, once it's cured, best association I could have is like the urethane from like a bouncy ball, how it becomes like solid and kind of bouncy and rubbery, but you can also peel it away in like these little chunks. So it has that type of consistency, which is good because you wanted to fill the spaces so the water does not flood the circuit board. And at the same time, you want to be able to service this later on and peel it away. So what happened was after it sank in the canal, I don't think it could have straightened out properly because the floaty was positioned like this. So it was constantly sort of in this position. So it was trying, like had air mode on. So it would just kind of like freak out and go one way or another and just kind of swim in a circle, but it still worked. And that was in briny salt water. So as you can hear, I'm gonna put it near my microphone, the motors sound great because I used the Corrosion X to kind of hopefully rust proof the motors as best as I could, and they seem fine. The air unit is toast because I did not waterproof that enough. I when after I opened it up I realized that I ignored my own advice to myself while working on this, which was to take your time. And I rushed it, and I only applied it to the outer, sort of like the SD card holder and the USB-C plug. But there's plenty of other holes and cracks in the air unit that allow it to get flooded with salty, briny water, and the circuits are fried. So I had one extra Cadex air unit, whatever, the small one. So I just put it in today and I'm testing it out. I've had a test flight and I have a full GoPro 10 on here. I want this to be like a filming rig, you know, something that I can like really depend on for filming cool videos over the water without fear of like having to replace parts. So the FPV Worry Free did its job. The ESC is untouched. The flight controller is untouched. You know, there's no rust or anything on it, and it looks like brand new in a way, you know? So that's really cool. So I'm trying to now sort of organize my thoughts, because the Vista is supposed to be like waterproof up to a point, right? I'm afraid that what I'm planning to do to it, I need to like really cover it well. So I'm gonna use the FPV Worry Free on the Vista unit. Well, you know, like hopefully I will figure that out. Like, you know, hopefully I'll get that formula down where I cover everything and there's no water like leaking into any type of like circuit boards or anything like that. So I'm just out here testing the flight characteristics with it, with the Vista, because it had the air unit on it. The air unit was just that extra X amount of grams was affecting its flight characteristics. And I just took it for a first time spin, and I have to hold myself back because it's flying incredibly well right now. I put the FPV cycle motors on here and almost super locked in feeling, if that makes sense, for me at least. Like I like trust the, when I drop out of like a dive, I can like land in like a good position. There's still a little bit of washout, but awesome, awesome. It's flying really good. So I'm gonna test that out. I'm getting kind of eaten by bugs out here, but it's beautiful. I'm not complaining at all. Very grateful to be out here. I'm gonna do a couple of flights. I'm gonna try not to lose it at any of these branches, trees, but like this thing makes me want to fly like faster. I'm gonna hop on the goggles. I'm gonna record myself, and then we'll kind of talk about the FPV Worry Free a little more. My thoughts on it, and I am excited to apply it to more drones and more circuit boards. All right, I'm gonna face that way. Recording, I think. Yes. Blind, legally blind, getting eaten by bugs. About two, an out of body experience. Yeah, comfortable. I feel like bugs are nibbling on my legs right now. It's really freaky. It's like little gnats. So, FPV Worry Free. There is some concern about components overheating when you apply this stuff, because there's nowhere for the heat to go if they are covered. But right now I am in 91 degree South Florida weather. It's hot, it's humid. I'm doing throttle punch outs and it's sounding good. Hopefully, you know, once we land, we'll check the motors, check the ESCs, all that good stuff. I probably should go land. This battery ran out real quick. Feels a little something. Can't tell what it is yet. That's the mode. Ooh, jeez. Just chopped up. Chopped myself up there. Oh great, I wasn't even recording any of that. So whew. Tell you, it's cooking right now. It's nice, but it's cooking. You just see flight controller temperature wise feel fine. This battery ran out really quick though. Maybe it's not doing so good. So the FPV worry-free stuff is, what I like about it is it goes on thick, not like conformal coating. Conformal coating feels like it would seep into sort of where the pin connectors meet and it would kind of ruin that connection, where the worry-free liquid is just goes on like in a thicker base, so it doesn't feel like it penetrates the actual electronic connections, you know, it doesn't cover those. So all the connection is still fine. And it kind of just like looks like an alien goop or like an epoxy or like a very flexible rubbery epoxy, you know? It's probably the best analogy that I can give it. I'm excited to try it out on my other builds. I actually have like an analog build that I wanna have be completely waterproof. And since the TBS Unify Nano is like this big, you could totally waterproof that, right? It's not like a Vista that's like a little block, you know? Because it just has a lot of surface area that you have to think about where the water might enter, you know? So I'm gonna do a couple more flights and call it a day. I'm excited because this seems to be very close to what I've been pursuing for a very long time, which is just like submerse, take out, rinse off, take back off. You know, and we're getting there. Exciting stuff, you know? I love making these little discoveries. Like, one of the things I learned about myself is that, like, I can't have someone else do it for me. I have to learn to do it myself and, like, engineer it, like, backwards in a way, or, like, reverse engineer it, if that makes any sense. To like learn the mistakes for myself so I know not to make those mistakes, instead of having somebody being like, here, this thing is waterproof. And I'm like, how? Now I'm like figuring out the how, if that makes any sense. So a couple more flights. Hope you enjoy. Thank you for tuning in. If you like what you've seen, if you found this even remotely informative, you know, give me a like, give me a subscribe. If you want to buy some music, go to udachi.bandcamp.com. I got all my beats on there. I'm also on Spotify, Apple Music, all that stuff. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That was cool. That. Yeah, we're good. We're good. Liking the way this thing is handling. Feels a little jumpy, but otherwise it feels really, really good. Okay, let's do one down. Scary. Gotta go get it.